Hello everyone, my name is Titus and today we are going to solve the following numerical on electrostatics, that is two charges Q and Q are placed at the diagonally opposite corners of a square while charges Q and Q are placed at the remaining corners. If the resultant force on one charge Q is zero, find the relation between Q and Q. So for this, first we'll draw a square of edge length, let us say A. So here we have a square. Let us name the square as A, B, C and D, where Q and Q are the charges placed diagonally opposite corner of the square and Q and Q are placed at this corner of the square. So let us now find the resultant force on this charge. As per the question, it is given that resultant force on, let us say, this charge is zero. So for that, either capital Q or small Q should be equal to 0, so that the negative charge and the positive charge force will balance each other. So let us assume that capital Q is negatively charged. This is minus and this is minus. And like I said, let the edge length be A. This is A, this is A, this is A. And as a result, the diagonal will be root 2 A by applying Pythagoras theorem. So now we can say AB is equal to A, BC is equal to A, DC equal to A, AD equal to A, AC is equal to C. So from the diagram we see that this charge is positive, this is negative. So if I want to find the force on this charge will pull it towards itself, that means along BC. Let the force on this charge due to this charge be F1. And force on this charge due to this charge be F2. Since it is attractive, it will pull towards itself and this charge will pull it towards itself. These two charges, they are negative, so this charge will have a tendency to push the charge radially outward. Let us call this to be F3. So here we say that F1 and F2 are perpendicular to each other. So applying Pythagoras theorem, we can find the resultant of these two forces. Let us say that Fr, that will be the resultant of F1 and F2, and that will be equal to F1 square plus F2 square under root, and it will be directed along the diagonal towards the negative charge. So I call this to be Fr. Now let us separately find out the forces. So F1 will be equal to K capital Q small q divided by A square. Here we are not taking the sign into consideration because due to the sign only we have already taken the direction of forces. So we are not taking the positive or the negative signs anymore. So F2 is equal to again K capital Q small q by A square. F1 is directed along the vertical direction and F2 is along the horizontal direction. And Fr is inclined at an angle of 45 degree to the horizontal as well as to the vertical. And F3, we can write F3 is equal to K capital Q into capital Q divided by root 2 A whole square, or that is equal to K capital Q capital Q by 2 A square. Fr is equal to F1 square plus F2 square. So I can write Fr is equal to KQ Q by A square whole square plus KQ Q by A square whole square under root. Or that will be equal to K capital Q small q by A square into 1 plus 1 whole square under root. Or we can further simplify and we can write Fr is equal to K capital Q small q divided by A square into root 2. From the question we see that the resultant force on charge Q is 0, and from the diagram we see that Fr and F3 are lying along one single line but they are oppositely directed. or we can write F R plus F 3 is equal to 0, that is the resultant force on charge capital Q, or F R is equal to minus of F 3. F R is equal to root 2 K capital Q small q divided by A square, and F 3 is equal to K capital Q divided by 2 A square. You can simplify it by cancelling 1 Q K K A square, and from here we get root 2 Q is equal to minus of Q by 2, or we can say Q is equal to minus of 2 root 2 Q. So this is the final expression.